What is the output of the following code snippet? So from ABC, import ABC meta abstract method. So when you see this statement in a program, so you'll know that it is abstract base class, right? Not just abstract base class, this class is also going to have an abstract method. Look at this class parent. You also have this meta class in which you mention ABC meta. So that is a syntax for declaring a abstract base class. So once you do this, this will be acting as an abstract base class. If a class is declared as a base class, it cannot be instantiated, number one. And number two, when you add this method, abstract method, in the first line, then which means you must have an abstract method in that class for sure. So show is basically an abstract method which has nothing. So this method needs to be implemented in the child class for sure. If you skip that, it doesn't work. So we got a, within this parent class constructor, we got a num is a member and value is 100. Then child, we are calling the parent class constructor. So whenever you create object for a child class, it goes to parent class. But what you have done is here, you have created a object for a parent class. So an abstract class cannot be instantiated. So which means abstract class cannot be instantiated. This should be the answer for the query. Answer for this question. So parent is an abstract class, and in line number 19, we're trying to create an object of parent class. This results in runtime error as an abstract class cannot be instantiated. We cannot create object of abstract class. Next question, what is the output of the following code snippet? So again, same class parent, there's an abstract class. Constructor, we have a member called num that is initialized to 5, and we have an abstract method. So if you see this word abstract method in the first line, import line, then you will definitely have something called abstract method. Then what is happening here in the child class? So we are invoking, super means to invoke parent class method. We are invoking super class parent here. Super class, base class. Super class means parent class, base class. Constructor there, so it will initialize. When this will be called, constructor will be called, when we create object for the class child. So we need to check from here. Yes, in line 18, we have created object for child. So what happens? Constructor will be called. Within this constructor, first line, that is 11th line itself, calling super class constructor. So this one will be called, and num will be initialized to 5. Then variable will be initialized to 10 here as a second step. Then you are calling out this method called show. So first you are printing num, second you are printing var. So value of num is 5, var value of var is 10. So this should be the answer. Then we go to the next quiz. So it is parent class, child class we have. So this is simply printing 100. You are not doing anything else there. So it should ensure that you got an abstract method. So abstract method is there. In the child class, you will have to implement that method, define that method. So look at this, in child class, you are not defined. So if you do not define in the child class, then this becomes an abstract class by default. That is the logic. Though you have created object for child, it does not create. Why? You have not defined an abstract method here. Why? Child is derived from the class parent. So whichever, if parent class has an abstract method, that must be derived here or implemented here. If you don't derive, then it is an error. So which means this one will become an abstract class. So abstract class cannot be instantiated. So simple thing, an abstract method must be overridden in the child class. If not, child class is considered as an abstract class. So next quiz, again the parent class has variable num. See, they are using same variable. Why? To make you familiarize with the concepts very clearly. So child class, which is inherited from a parent class. Now look at this. So this class has an abstract method. The child class is not deriving or overriding this method show here. So what happened? What will happen? This will become an abstract class. The grandchild, they are overriding the method. So what we are doing? We are look from this line number 20. We are creating object for a grandchild. We cannot create object for parent class and child class. Why? Parent class is an abstract class. Child class is not overriding the abstract method which is available in the parent class. So child class also becomes an abstract class. So for both abstract classes, we cannot create object. So what happens? Only for a grandchild, this another third level inherited class, we can create an object. With that, we are calling show. So when you call show, it prints. So when you create object, so which means it has access to child and parent class by default. So initially 5, then 10. We are printing self.num, then self.where, then this is possible. So 5, 10, this is possible. So quiz 49, class A, it has in it just a print statement inside, then it has an abstract method. This has an abstract method. A has an abstract method named as method 1. So that whichever class is derived, A, for example, B is derived from A, it has to override method 1. But what they have done, they have created a new method called method 2, which means creating object for both class A and B not possible. So it will throw error. Class B, you are trying to create an object for B, so it is not possible.